Let's talk about 4K. What is it? How good is it? Should you care? Here's the executive summary. 4K is the latest high-resolution video format. Most people don't need to care about 4K for the foreseeable future, but if you're rich or have a specific need, 4K might be an option. And one day, 4K will be a mainstream resolution. Current HD televisions are 1920 pixels wide and 1080 pixels high. 4K or ultra high definition television is 4 times that, so it's like putting 4 full HD screens next to each other, giving you a resolution of 3840 pixels by 2160. The name 4K refers to the approximate number of horizontal pixels. Unfortunately, this is the television 4K standard. The cinema version of 4K is slightly wider, so accommodating different aspect ratios is still a problem in 4K. How good is 4K? Well, it is very good. I'd say the jump from HD to 4K is similar to the old jump from standard definition to HD, but maybe not quite as dramatic. You get the best effect being fairly close, where you can see a whole new level of detail. From further back, it looks more like a normal HD image, but the advantage here is that you can have a much bigger screen and longer viewing distances than traditional HD TVs. Let's have a look at some of the pros and cons, starting with some of the most common criticisms. The big one is the price. In 2013, it's well out of reach for most people. There is a market, and a local Sony rep confirmed that they have sold a few units. It just won't be a mass market until the price drops quite a lot. But of course, that's always the case with new tech. The rich people get to play first, and the rest of us have to wait. The next criticism is that you don't actually get the full benefit of the higher resolution in most home theater setups. Unless you're using a very large screen, say 55 inches or higher, you're probably not going to see the full benefit. That's a valid point, and you'll want to think very carefully about whether your room really needs anything more than normal high definition. Then there's the issue of content. There's very little available in native 4K yet, and most users will be relying on upscaling, which I'll talk about shortly. As far as native 4K goes, television broadcasts won't be going 4K for years, if ever, and personally, I'd rather see them improve the HD compression that already makes HD look like rubbish, rather than worrying about more pixels. There are plans to distribute native 4K movies, and Sony has a temporary method in place, but there aren't yet any standardized 4K distribution channels. On the other hand, if you look at YouTube and other video sharing sites, you'll see the number of 4K videos is exploding. This is a great opportunity for independent filmmakers to fill the content gap and get themselves noticed. But realistically, if you want mainstream TV or blockbuster movies in 4K, you'll need some patience. Now let's have a look at some of the good things about 4K. Picture quality. Like I said earlier, native 4K is really good. There's no doubt that the quality is a win. Because of the lack of native content, for now most people will need to upscale normal HD content, which means converting it to 4K on the fly. This isn't as good as native 4K content, but it's better than normal HD, so it's still an improvement, at least for most people. Not everyone likes upscaled images, but from what I've seen, most people do. I was certainly very impressed by Sony's upscaling engine, which they call X-Reality Pro. So, you might be quite happy with no native 4K content at all, just a better way to show existing HD. 3D is much better and more flexible. For example, the big problem with TVs that use passive 3D glasses is that the resolution is cut in half. That's why so many people recommend active shutter systems, but they have their own problems, including very expensive glasses. With a 4K TV, you can halve the resolution and still deliver 1080p to each eye. In other words, proper high definition 3D with cheap glasses that don't need batteries. And this leads to one of the things I think a lot of commentators are overlooking. The idea that 4K isn't just a higher resolution, it can be used in other ways. It can be a single 4K image, or it can be two simultaneous 1080p images when used with glasses. And that's not just useful for 3D. For example, a lot of games in two-player mode split the screen into two views, one for each player. And as you play, each player watches their own view. But using a technique similar to 3D, you can now show two completely separate full-screen HD views at the same time, one to each player. so you're both watching the same screen but seeing completely different things. This is a really big deal for gaming. And taking it further, you could even show two different movies or TV channels at the same time. You'd need headphones, and it's not the most social way to watch stuff, but I can see a use for it. So even if a full 4K image isn't particularly useful for you, the dual stream 1080 might be. Getting back to the single 4K image, it's not just a video content viewer. For example, if you use your TV as a computer monitor, you probably find the 1080 resolution a bit on the low side. With a 4K TV, you're spoilt for screen space and there's all sorts of new possibilities. For example, you could have an oversized screen and watch TV content in a window that you adjust to be the right size for your room. It's still better than HD, and you can have other related contents or apps in smaller windows around it. Those are some ideas for in the home, but there are other markets too. 4K is going to be great in public display areas. Right now, I'm working with an organization that uses this area for giving presentations, and they want to add 3D to the system. So far, we've looked at a bunch of projectors and HD TVs, but they've all got serious problems. A 4K TV between, say, 84 and 100 inches would solve all these problems and have a much nicer image. So even at $20,000, there's a business case to be made here. So, in summary, obviously a better picture. Screens can be much bigger, or with the same size screen, you can sit closer. Passive 3D becomes a real option, and there are lots of possibilities with dual stream 1080p images. The obvious immediate problems are the price and lack of content, but these will be fixed eventually. Of more concern is that on a TV less than about 50 inches at a typical viewing distance, the difference between 1080p and 4K is marginal at best. So 4K isn't something you're likely to purchase for quite a while, but it is an exciting new format and I'm sure it has a future. I just hope the discussions about 4K can include all the different applications and not just whether you can find and fit a native 4K movie in your lounge. There's so much more to it than that. As always, I'll enjoy reading all your comments. Just please note that I do delete offensive comments. I don't care if you disagree with me, but if you want your comment to stay, then it's best not to get all Tarantino with your language. Other than that, let fly with your thoughts, and thanks for watching. Bye.